Hello and welcome to my final year dissertation demo, which is a touchless attendance system using deep facial recognition. First, we'll get to the aims and objectives, and then we'll review the architectural system. Finally, we'll get to the demo where we will see the deployment of the deep learning model and the overview of the GUI. And then we will detect the faces in different conditions to test it, and then we will see the result and conclusion. For the aims and objectives, users should have full control of the attendance taking process. This is done using a GraphQL user interface. The GraphQL user interface is made using Tkinter, which is a built-in Python default library. Python was used because of its frameworks and libraries available such as NumPy, Pandas, TensorFlow, and OpenCV, which is used for image processing. The system should be efficient in the use of resources, should also provide accurate detection using the deep learning model, and real-time multiple face detection should be achieved. It is expected that the system should detect only live faces only. In the architectural design, the first step is the student enrollment. First, data gathering takes place using the web camera of the laptop, which is already accessible. A number of face images are captured and then stored in the database. Firstly, OpenCV was used using HawkCascade, but it was not so accurate and was not using deep learning, but it was fast. FaceNet MTCNN was then used, which provided much better accuracy when detecting faces, and especially in low lighting conditions. When training the recognizer, weights are created. During the recognition process, the student walks in front of the camera. The student faces are detected in real time. Faces are cropped from each frame. The face is compared against the database to create the liveness mask or known faces. Attendance is marked as present for recognized faces with a confirmation audio and visual message. The database used was text file instead of MySQL because the database would have been too large because images would be stored as blobs in the database. Instead, the images are stored locally so that it is lightweight. So now for the demonstration of the system features, we will launch the virtual environment first, and then we will launch the main application. And when the lecturer launches the system for the first time, he will be prompted with a menu to enter his details for first time registration. So now, a second time he will launch it, he will have to enter his password. He will be directed to a menu. In the menu, he will have the option for classroom attendance, time in, time out attendance, change his details or exit. So let's change his details. We'll see he will be able to update his details. Update his password here. So let's cancel that. Now we will go on the class attendance. So we will have to choose the class. So, and we'll also have the option to add a new class. So here he'll be able to enter a new class he teaches. So let's choose computer vision. Let's launch the system. So here he will be prompted with the main application. Here he will have the option to toggle on and off the attendance taking process. In white we have a table for the real-time attendance for that day, for that particular module. And at the bottom right he will have a clock which shows the real time for students to see at what time they have reached the class. So next we will choose a new student. So let's add a student with ID. So Now let's take the images. So here he will be able to press on take images for the system to take images for the training process. So the frames from the camera are taken and face detection takes place. As you can see, a bounding box is done at the face, and each image taken is stored in a database. So it will take 10 images according to testings. Test images prove sufficient enough for the deep learning model FaceNet to work properly. So after that, he'll be able to add other students. If not, he will press back, and then he'll have the option to train the profile. So let's press train the one profile. So here a progress bar shows the progress, and then when the training has finished, we can see that a confirmation message is displayed. And for the training of 1, 2, 3, 4 students, we have got 1 minute for the training time. The students' details are added in the pictures are added in the folder under which he has all the pictures as seen here. So the image was cropped, and the ID also is appended as a name. And the student details are stored in the student details folder. So as you can see here, we have all the details for the students and the registration time. The toggle button is pressed so that the FaceNet model is loaded. Face detection takes place, and then faces are cropped and then compared from the database. So the frames from the camera are being taken for processing. So the deep learning model is quite heavy, so that's why it is taking a bit of time.
Hello, Kevin Radhu.
So now you can see that the system calls out my name, saying that it has been detected, and it takes a confidence level of 70%, and then the recognition distance of at least 50 centimeters, and then it detects whether the face found is known or unknown. If it is known, then the bounding box has a name to it. If it is unknown, it will display unknown. It then performs mask detection to see if the person is putting a mask. So if it is putting a mask, then it will tell to remove the mask, as shown here. And then it also detects if it is a fake or real face. So as you can see here, it has told me to remove the mask temporarily. So for mask detection, it has a bounding box which is blue. So for liveness detection, it detects whether it is a real or fake face. So it can put, if someone puts an image from a camera of someone, let's say my friend Adila, and then it will put it in a red bounding box.
It can be observed that since the net model is so processing intensive, the recordings of where sometimes struggles. From time to time it stalls. And when the real-time attendance is shown here on the table, and the time of entry is also recorded. So to toggle the attendance off, the lecturer has to press the off button here, and then an attendance summary is generated. So this attendance summary shows how many real images, how many fake images, and how many masked images were present, and whether the number of out of four people, only me was present. So a quarter is present and three quarter is absent. And then the user has also the option to send a mail to the lecturer. For time in, time out, check in, check out system, in the menu you have to press the option and then add the details. For example, for an exam, the duration, you have to enter the duration and then choose which class it is and then launch the attendance. And then when students will enter the class, it will record the attendance, and then after the duration it will re-enter, it will re-record the attendance as timeout. So here you can see we are time in, time out column.
The system is tested with varying face positions. Good performance is noticed as the prediction is almost 100%. The system is also tested for varying facial emotions. Initially, multi-threading was used first, but later it was migrated to multiprocessing because memory space was not needed to be shared among the different functionalities implemented. Next, the system is tested for varying lighting conditions. It can be noticed that instead of using two different MTCNN models, the face mask and liveness detection was combined into only one detector. Next, we will vary the camera position of the detector. For the detection of the lower part of the face. The distance from the camera is also varied. Here we can see that I am standing at a distance of about 4 meters from the camera source. And then different face obstructions position are compared. The fake and unknown faces are added in a folder when they are detected, and then they are sent to the lecturer. MTCNN was used to train the mask, real, and fake images for the liveness detector and the mask detection. Their respective weights were generated, and then they were used for the detection phase.
Hello, Kevin Radhu.
Now testing will be done with two people. To the right, as you can see, real-time attendance is being taken and is being updated in the Excel format. And when the second person comes, and when it is detected. Now let's test with both people at the same time for multiple real-time detection. As you can see, it is detected as unknown for the other frames because of the lighting conditions. But even though in low lighting condition, it works properly. Multiple can be detected at the same time in real time. This is possible. And then when the attendance process is finished, a statistical summary is displayed
as you can see, out of only two people were present out of five people. To conclude, the system requires no human intervention at all when the lecturer has launched the attendance taking process, as long as students come and wait momentarily in front of the camera. The system is made in such a way for even novice users to use the system easily, as it contains graphs, tables for information. Different face recognition methods were explored, such as Hall Cascade, but FaceNet proved to be the best performing as it performed perfectly well in low lighting conditions. When detecting faces, an audio and visual confirmation are given. The system will even work with new internet connection, hence a standalone system. The FaceNet model is highly accurate, but at the expense of computing power. The frame rate is only about 1.5 frames per second. Due to current conditions, extensive testing were not properly done. More testing needs to be done in the classroom with about 100 or 150 students instead of 5 right now. We now come to the end of the video. Thank you for your time for watching.